Welcome to Children's Ministry at the Fort Bend Church. My name is Miss Brittany. It's time for prayer. Let us pray. Dear God, please hear our prayer. We praise your holy name. We thank you for your love. We thank you, God, for Jesus, who died on the cross for our sins. Dear God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the Bible. We thank you for our church. We thank you for our pastor. We thank you for our parents. We thank you for our teachers. We thank you for our friends. We love you, God, our Father. Dear God, help us to obey you and make you smile. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. It's time for praise and worship. Let's stand and sing, This Is the Day.
This is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. This is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made, we will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. This is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made, we will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made.
In today's Bible story, Doers of the Word, James wrote to believers and told believers to do what God says. James said that anyone who hears God's word but does not do it is like someone who sees himself in the mirror and forgets what he looks like. Let's listen to the story to hear what else James has to say. Our story point is James reminded believers to do what Jesus said. Let's watch the story video.
Hi, I'm Megan, and this is my friend Jesse.
Jesse?
Oh, hi.
Jesse, what are you doing with that mirror?
Oh, I was just looking at my hair. I just got a haircut. Doesn't it look so different?
Well, I don't know about different, but it definitely looks good.
Oh, thank you.
You know what? James talks about a person looking at themselves in a mirror in today's Bible story.
He does?
Yep. Listen to the story from the Bible.
James was a leader in the early church. He wrote a letter to believers who were living in many different places. James told them how believers should live. James wrote, "Do what God says. If you hear God's word but don't do it, you trick yourselves. Anyone who hears the word but does not do it is like someone who sees himself in the mirror and then forgets what he looks like. Anyone who hears and does God's word will be blessed. James said that people who really love God will love people too. God is honored when Christians show their faith by doing what is right and good, like helping people who have no one to take care of them. James also wrote, "Brothers and sisters, if someone is cold and hungry, and you say, 'Go in peace, stay warm and full,' but you do not give him clothes or food, what good does that do? In the same way, faith in God without action is no good. Anyone can say, 'I have faith,' but we know someone has true faith by what he does." James reminded the believers of Abraham and Rahab. Abraham had true faith. We know this because he obeyed God when God asked him to do very hard things. Rahab had true faith too. We know this because she hid spies in Jericho, even though it was dangerous. God does not accept people because they do what is good and right. He accepts people who trust in Jesus. Those who are accepted into God's family will do what is good and right because God loves them. Jesus said, "If anyone loves me, he will keep my word." James reminded believers to do what Jesus said. Jesus takes our punishment for sin so we can live for him. When we trust in Jesus, we can do what is good and right.
James wrote a letter to believers in the early church telling them how they should live. James reminded believers to do what Jesus said. God does not accept people because they do what's good and right. He accepts people who trust in him. Jesus takes our punishment for sins so we can live for him. Those who are accepted into God's family will do what is good and right because God loves them. Our key passage says that we are many, but we are one body in Christ. Those who believe in Jesus are one big happy family. The church cares for one another. Let's recite the key passage. We who are many are one body in Christ. Romans 12 and 5. Let's sing the key passage song, One Body in Christ, and the theme song, One Foundation.
We are many, one body,
one body.
We who Church is one foundation, is Jesus Christ her Lord. She is his new creation by water and the word. From heaven he came and sought her to be his holy bride. With his own blood he bought her, and for her life he died. One
The big picture question is, what is the church? The answer is, the church is all Christians everywhere. When we trust in Jesus, we become a part of the church, and God is honored when the church shows its faith by doing what is right and good. James reminded believers to do what Jesus said. Missionaries like Philip and Jumai Nash showed through their actions that Jesus is most important in their lives. They moved to America from an African country called Nigeria. Our gospel gems remind us people are saved by faith in Jesus. The Bible tells us how to obey God, and believers show the world that Jesus has changed us. I hope you've enjoyed today's lesson. For the mission moment, let's look at the pictures from Nigeria called the Early Church. Then work on your activity pages with your parents. Remember to subscribe to the Fort Bend Church's YouTube channel, like and share this week's video. See you next time. Bye.
Minneapolis and St. Paul, Minnesota are often referred to as the Twin Cities. People from all over the world are moving to these cities. Even people from warm places are coming to brave Minnesota winters. In fact, of the more than 3 million people who call the Twin Cities home, 1 out of 4 are immigrants. People who were born in a different country but have moved to the United States for work. There are lots of old churches in the cities, and most people are open to hearing about church things. Often, however, they don't want to know more. But there are those in the Twin Cities that want more for the people. Missionaries and local pastors want everyone in their cities to have a personal relationship with Jesus. They are training local believers to have deeper conversations about Jesus and the Bible. We can partner with the Twin Cities through prayer and ask that everyone living there will be able to hear and understand the saving grace of God's love through His Son, Jesus.